is going to be good. What is going on, guys? It is Ryan, and we're back again with another video. This time, it is the first Tutorial Tuesday. If you guys didn't see my latest video, which was actually posted early this morning, I announced my brand new video schedule. And coming to you right on schedule is Tutorial Tuesday, the very first. This is the start of something great. I'm excited. All right, let's dive into this. As you can tell by the title of the video right down there, what we are talking about today is editing your photos with presets, specifically in Adobe Lightroom. So many comments, so many DMs, Snapchats, Instagram DMs, you name it, pretty much anywhere and everywhere, people are asking me how I'm editing my photos, what programs I'm using. And of course, the answer to that is I'm primarily using Adobe Lightroom. I do use Photoshop a bit, but besides the point. Today, I'm gonna take you guys through the simple workflow that I use for editing the majority of my photos. I've created a brand new pack for you guys down in the description. Go check it out. 6 of my all new, freshly developed presets. Super excited to actually start using these because I spent a ton of time trying these on tons and tons of different photos and just like really making them work for so many different scenarios. So these are probably some of my best presets I've made to date. That's why I'm actually so excited to make them available for you guys. But without further ado, let's jump into this. Let's get the screen recording going here. Okay. This is the first time I've actually done a tutorial on Mac, so this is different. Right on my desktop, I have my preset pack already downloaded and extracted, just chilling there, waiting to be used. We'll go ahead and open up Adobe Lightroom, get that going. Also, I'm pretty sure that the screen recording is gonna be pretty tolling on my system here, and plus I'm running on a not super powerful MacBook. So I'm guessing the fan is gonna get pretty noisy here in just a little bit. All right, so we're in Adobe Lightroom here and I have 6 example photos already selected. I'm gonna take you through the process of utilizing these presets and editing a few photos here, kind of show you the workflow and how it all blends together. First things first, let's go ahead and import those presets. Over on the left-hand side here in the presets panel, you're gonna right click in kind of just a blank gray area, click new folder. We're gonna name this whatever you want. I've actually already done this, so I don't really need to do it. And on that new folder that you just created, right click again and hit import. Now from there, you're gonna navigate to where you downloaded the presets, and I'm already in the folder here. And you can actually do a command A or just drag and select all of them and click import. Now when you open up that folder, they're all gonna be there. Mine all have a 2 after them because in the folder right above this one, I've already done this. So I'm actually just gonna go ahead and delete this. All right, so let's open up that folder and here they are, 6 awesome presets that I've just freshly developed. We have Blue Steel, Clean Film, Epic BW, which stands for Epic Black and White, Faded Film, Sunshine Warmth, and Vibrant Film. Now you'll notice multiple of these have film in the name. All of them are kind of a film look, kind of dramatic, contrasty film. If you guys are following me on Instagram, you'll know that that's kind of my personal flavor that I like to add on top of my photos, kind of a dramatic film look, usually a good amount of contrast and film grain. These aren't too intense, not quite as intense as I would use in some of my own personal stuff, but definitely it's going to give you guys a nice film kind of vintage feel to your work. Now, presets like these aren't always exactly the kind of look that I'm going to be delivering to clients, but again, this is kind of my own personal taste. So the photo that you're looking at right here is actually utilizing the clean film preset. So let's show you guys a full before and after the photo. So here is before. Dark, flat, boring, needs a boost of exposure, needs honestly a boost of everything. And here's what we get after. Here is another example photo. This is a before. I apply the Blue Steel preset on top of this guy. This preset kind of drops down the shadows and the blacks and pumps up the highlights and then adds kind of a cool iron blue steel type tone to the image, really just giving it this sort of deep, punchy feel. Really, really like this one. Another example photo here of these goats. This was when I was out in Wyoming doing kind of a trip with some of my photographer friends. I applied the faded film preset over the top of this guy. This one, quite clearly, as the name states, is sort of a faded film look. So you're gonna get some nice soft highlights and midtones, rich saturation, but at the same time, on the curves, the blacks are gonna be kind of flattened out. So it's gonna give you that sort of fade look that's really, really popular. That's really, really popular on Instagram right now. All right, so this next one, I'm gonna apply the preset Epic Black and White. Quick disclaimer, I'm a really big fan of like super dramatic, super contrasty black and white. Now, some people kind of like the more classic, kind of neutral black and white photos. I'm personally kind of like towards the opposite end of that spectrum, where it's like I like the most aggressive, punchy, like just dramatic black and white photos. So this preset is going to give you pretty much exactly that. Super dramatic black and white. You guys are going to love this one. Here is the before of kind of a nice backlit portrait. And then I applied the sunshine warmth preset to this guy. Really dramatic difference. Now, obviously there's a little bit of tweaking with exposure and everything that kind of, you know, brought this photo to life, but the preset really carries all the color. You get the point. Last but not least is actually my favorite preset of the entire bunch, because I actually have used this one and kind of manipulated it over a period of time now. This one is called Vibrant Film. Here's the before photo, again, kind of a backlit sunny portrait. Boom. Okay, so let's take some of these photos and completely reset all the settings and take you from start to finish with these presets. Command Shift R removes all of our settings here, even the crop, everything. So the way I've designed these presets is to pretty much take care of everything except for exposure, contrast, and crop for you guys. Keep in mind, these presets were also designed to be utilized with raw photos. So if you're shooting on, you know, a phone or a camera in JPEG mode, you may have slightly different results with how the photos handle these colors that are going to be, you know, applied over the top with the preset. But if you can, shoot in raw and you'll get the best results possible here. To start off with this photo, I'm gonna go ahead and take and mess with the exposure here. This definitely needs to come up quite a bit, right around there. Also just a touch of contrast. That's about right. I'm also gonna adjust the crop. I want his head kind of a little bit closer to this top third of the frame. So I'm just gonna pull this in. Perfect, that's looking pretty good. So, like I said, all you really need to do is just adjust the crop, exposure, contrast, and then you can pretty much just apply the preset from there. So I originally had, in the example, the clean film preset applied, but let's try something different. Let's try the vibrant film. Simple as that. I mean, seriously, like I said, all you really need to do is mess with exposure and contrast, and you can pretty much drop these presets on anywhere. So like I said, with my LUT pack, with my color grading tutorial, which link will be down in the description, go check that out if you haven't seen it already. Play around with every one of these, use it on tons of different photos, try every single one and just see how they work and what they do better in certain scenarios. Different lighting situations in terms of, you know, if it's a backlit portrait or if it's a dramatic landscape with a sunset, all of them are going to handle these presets just a little bit differently. So again, experimentation is kind of necessary. The great thing is with these presets, we can just as easily change it to a different one by just clicking. We can try faded film. Looks amazing, honestly. Like I'm really happy with these presets and how they came out. We can try blue steel. Let's go ahead and try a different example photo. This shot right here is of my buddy Chris out in a forest near the Oregon coast. I'm gonna go ahead and reset all the settings here. Command Shift R once again. Takes it back to the original. Go ahead and tweak the exposure and contrast a little bit here. Bring up the exposure just a tad. A little bit of contrast. Originally I had blue steel on this photo, so let's try, how about sunshine warmth? This doesn't look quite as ideal as I'd like it to. Again, the, you know, each of these are kind of going to need their own little bit of manipulation here and there with some of the basic correction in order to get to look ideal, but I can very simply kind of tweak it here by bringing up our white balance, kind of warming things up. Playing with our highlights a little bit, we can kind of bring these guys down just a tad, playing with our shadows. And now I think we're looking a lot better, something a lot closer to what I anticipated with this preset. But that's it, guys. That is how brutally simple it is to utilize these presets and just immediately bump up your results and step up that game to get that really awesome sort of vintage film look. I'm really hoping that you guys enjoy these. Leave a comment down below if you decide to pick them up, and I'd love to see what you guys create with them. That being said, I'm gonna go ahead and end the video here, guys. Thank you so much for watching the very first Tutorial Tuesday. Oh, I'm so excited for this new schedule. I can't express it enough. I'm too hyped up right now. Like, this is ridiculous. Please give this video a thumbs up for the new schedule and for awesome tutorials, and just give it a thumbs up. You know the drill. Subscribe if you haven't already. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Me. Yeah. Two zips. It's lit. Bang. Roll. Can't fit. Squat. Shit. All of my